Molecular biologists are often looking at DNA single-stranded. So the question they would be asking is, where is this piece that I'm interested in? Where can I find that? The way they do it is with hybridization. Let's say, for example, you have a strand of DNA and it's got an A, G, C, T, A, G. If a strand comes along that's complementary to this one, which would be T, C, G, A, T, C, then the strand will find its match and hybridize with it. So the idea of hybridization is that if two strands are completely compatible, they will spontaneously find each other and match up. And that's about all there is to it. In molecular biology, it's common to have like the needle in the haystack scenario. You have a stretch of DNA and you want to know where it's found within a billion bases. You want to know where can I find this? So a technique would be to label the DNA you have, which would be like with a radioisotope or something like that, some kind of fluorescent marker, and then mix it in single-stranded with other single-stranded and see where it matches up. Single-stranded DNA is not a common occurrence in a cell, but it's a very important foundation for many of the tools in molecular biology.